No, but
so let's be sensible,
what are the concessions we're talking about?
Let's not be political and partisan.
What are the concessions?
I have a large number.
Like what?
Well, certainly more than happened during Kargil or Parliament attack. I repeated them just a minute ago.
But what? Please answer the question.
No,
what?
Pakistan, yeah. I perhaps you are not hearing, Kasab is a Pakistan national. Kasab is supported by others from Pakistani soil. Some of the others are under trial in Pakistan.
All of that effectively means nothing because the trial there hasn't taken off for any practical purpose.
You come back to my point. I'd like to give the reins of power to Mr. Jaipurani to tell us how he'd like to bomb Pakistan into anything more.
Can I ask you a very simple question? Isn't there surely a choice between all-out war and diplomacy? I mean, I'm
asking you to tell me the choice right now. Frontally to tell me a choice.
Mahesh Jaipurani?
Give me one single answer.
I've already answered that question. I would have said
none.
No dialogue. Your diplomacy is an abject failure. You are not able to get anything. In fact, whenever you talk to them, they extract more concessions from you rather than you extracting concessions from them. And if you think it's a great achievement to get Pakistan to admit that Kasab, your biggest achievement to get Pakistan to admit that Kasab is a Pakistani, you know, your measure of success is pathetic. A. B. Let me tell you something. If you chose not to, every time you've gone to them, you've given up Baluchistan. Your Prime Minister has practically admitted during talks at Sharm el Sheikh that we are interfering in Baluchistan. And on top of that now, Mr. Qureshi, as I pointed out earlier, has now said that you should move on. While you're dialoguing with Mr. Qureshi, the foreign minister, he has told you in no uncertain terms that please forget 2611 and move on.
Okay.
What kind of diplomacy have you? Yours is the most abject thing.
Okay.
You are obsequious towards Pakistan.
Let me answer that. One second.
All right.
The only point which Jaipurani makes is sit in a corner and sulk. That is belied by the three concrete instances I gave of Mr. Vajpayee and the NDA government of his own party to which he belongs. And certainly the surrender is not half as abject as the Kandahar. It is not a surrender as abject as Kargil or as Parliament attack.
Can I just get quick words in from both Mr. Kazmi and Mr. YP Singh? Mr. YP Singh, at the end of the I'm still coming back to that point. Look at, for example, what America is doing in the case of this gentleman called Raymond Allen Davis. Even President Obama is putting pressure on Pakistan to release him, a man who was seen shooting at two Pakistani nationals in Pakistan. I mean, shouldn't we be using that kind of leverage, that kind of instruments of leverage against Pakistan? Mr. Singh?
Yes, certainly, because given constraints which are there with Pakistan, that it's a country which is most reluctant to investigate 2611. We could have used certain tools to ensure that we could get best out of it, but that was incumbent on the efficiency of the investigating agencies, which was lacking quite substantially. It is something very rudimentary and in investigation that when Headley was caught in US, the first and the foremost and basic thing was to seek an extradition of that person to India, because with India and US we had an extradition treaty. Now, we couldn't do even such basic things. Similarly, Mumbai police, Fahim Ansari, Indian part of the conspiracy, we put up for false evidences which were so confirmed by the lower court and the high court, no responsibility. So I think when our own investigating agencies are faltering, we will be unable to convince Pakistan of doing something substantial against these people, and perhaps because of our own failure that Pakistan